Hi, this is George Katouf for AgelessTimeless.com, where we try to answer the question, what do you expect for someone my age? Our response, excellence. We try to interview individuals over the age of 50 or those that contribute to the individuals over the age of 50 to ensure that we're doing everything possible to maximize our health potential. Because remember, your body is a temple. It's a real pleasure for me today to interview this beautiful and talented woman. She has written over 13 books in the Eat Clean series. She's a New York Times bestseller as far as an author. She also has competed in physique competitions, placed in the top five in all of them. She's a nutritional therapist, motivational speaker, and been on the cover of many major magazines, and I know has impacted on a number of people throughout her life. She has a very purposeful life. So without further ado, Tosca Reno, thank you for giving me the opportunity to interview you today.
Oh, George, thank you for putting that in my hands. I'm so grateful for this beautiful opportunity and the chance to talk about the things that we're so passionate about, right? Which is keeping ourselves well late in life.
Exactly. Well, that's the thing. As you and I have talked in the past, you have not necessarily always been the person we see right now. There was a change around 2000. What happened to you that got you on this road to health and fitness?
George, like so many things in life, I had to fall first before I could get up. And so the path to my success was definitely through some failures, namely that I had become an overweight woman, obese actually. I weighed 204 pounds and was suffering from various illnesses or disorders that go along with being overweight. It's ridiculous to think that you're just going to have extra pounds and no other consequences. So I was starting to have difficulties with my heart. My father had died of heart disease at the age of 64. I was experiencing all the symptoms that go along with blood sugar dysregulation. I hadn't been diagnosed yet, but there are many people out there just like me. So I knew that something was really wrong. And also, I had an aha moment, a crystallizing moment where I wanted to walk up the stairs, and my house was a Victorian house, narrow, steep steps. I just wanted to say goodnight to my daughters, three little babies that I wanted to say goodnight to. And I couldn't make it up the stairs that day. And that was the day that I thought, this ends now. And that was the beginning of.
So right at that epiphany, you started to change your life. How did you do it? How did you make this metamorphosis? Because certainly now you've become an inspiration to so many people. How did you start to lose the weight and get in shape?
George, I started by recruiting myself first. I had to believe that I needed to get well. And I had to believe that it was possible. I had to see it even before I had actually accomplished it. So I acted on those thoughts because, as we know, all thought becomes action. It becomes creativity. So I went to my local gym. I hired a personal trainer. I knew nothing about weights. I'm embarrassed. I didn't know what a triceps was. And I also made a decision that day, George, to get out of an abusive marriage. So I had to advocate for myself as well as recruit myself. And that it was a lot of work because I didn't have a lot around me to show positivity. I really had a lot to walk away from. And then just putting myself in the path of those decisions and those changes that would really ultimately have such an impact on me, lined me up with the right people, because that's what happens, right? The universe provides, and lined me up with the right people so that I met Robert Kennedy, He challenged me to do my first ever contest, which was a bodybuilding contest. I competed at the age of 42. And from that experience, I learned everything about how my body works, how to eat clean, how to recruit positive mindset, and just everything. It was just remarkable.
Were you a teacher at the time when you met Robert? Robert, by the way, became your husband.
Yeah, he did. I was a teacher. I was teaching his daughter in grade one, and I had made a decision to go back to school as a mature student so that I could get work, because I knew I was planning to leave father of my children to get myself out of that abusive situation. So I thought, well, school teaching would be awesome. So I'll go back to school as a, 40 something woman. And that's how all the pieces came together.
I see. Well, in watching you, I note that one of the things that you are passionate about is the fact that sugar needs to be removed from the diet as much as possible. I assume that you're not getting a lot of invitations from executives from the sugar industry to have dinner together. Is that correct?
That is precisely true. I got a mark on my back, probably. yes, I read a powerful book when I started my wellness journey back then, 20 years ago. I read a powerful book called Sugar Blues by William Duffy. And knowing that I was severely blood sugar dysregulated, I felt like I was reading a book about myself. And then matching that up with the positives of eating clean, namely, you're not eating any refined sugar, you're not eating refined grains, you're not eating refined foods of any kind, you're eating a lot of lean protein, lots of fresh fruit, vegetables, less fruit, more vegetables, and some grains, but they're properly prepared. I healed myself, and I've experienced this within my own body, and everything about me changed. My attitude, my mind, my mood, my energy, my libido, hormonal irritations, everything. The depression seemed to go away, and suddenly I had this new zest for life. And I pin it all down on sugar, because I was a sugar addict before, and then suddenly I wasn't. And the difference was, you could see it. It was tangible. It was now this new creative force in me.
It's very difficult to rid yourself of sugar based on the amount of processed foods that the typical SAD diet, that's the standard American diet, everything that's packaged, almost everything, is laced with sugar. And in fact, I watched something the other day. Dr. Michael Greger had a presentation, a short video, and he was talking about sugar intake among teenagers in the United States. And it appears that teenagers consume about 29 packets of sugar daily. So your premise is right on target. But how do you advise people to rid themselves of that addiction? And that's exactly what it is.
Yeah. Well, you have to recognize it is an addiction, and you have to want the change first. As in, when I first made a decision to change my life 20 years ago, I had to have the thought first. I had to have the idea that this is not good. And that can come from, experiences, your health. It can come from watching a video like what you watched. But what I do is I've created a program based on sound nutritional principles called Strike Sugar. And actually, I'm running a special on it. I have been running a special on it all week. But to me, this is where the wellness begins. I don't think anybody can make any tangible wellness change until they remove sugar out of the diet first. And the reason I believe that is because sugar is a toxin that creeps into all your organs, and it creeps into your bones. And sugar, and I'm talking about refined sugar and foods that translate into that type of sugar in the body, is a thief. So the body doesn't see sugar as food. It's not a food. In fact, in the Greek alphabet, where most of our language comes from, there's no word. They have word for honey, but not sugar. So this is a thing we made up. And the body does not recognize sugar as food. The body sees it as a toxin when it comes in. So it has to make decisions about what to do with this ingredient that's suddenly appeared in its body. And it has to make a decision. I'm going to put this sugar in fat because fat is a safe storage place for all toxins. Or I'm going to have to use some precious minerals to get rid of the sugar, which is what it does. Sugar actually leaches minerals out of your bones and your organs on its way out. And then, you know, just think about all the toxicities that go with it, the weight gain, the disease, illness, all the rest of it. Actually, cancer's favorite food is sugar. So that's why I think you need to go right down to basics and spend at least 4 weeks cleansing your body, resetting the organs of blood sugar handling, and removing sugar from your diet. Now, many of the people that I've worked with prefer to use that as their template going forward and will do it sometimes around 12 weeks, and many just do it for life. I'm a non-sugar eater for my life. I just don't need it. I don't crave it anymore. I've healed myself completely. And I think the benefits are just way too grand to ignore.
There are those that push back in the other direction. And there are those who might say, I'm overweight, I'm out of shape, but I'm beautiful anyway, and just accept me as I am. What do you say to that?
Well, I accept the premise of the fact that we are all created by the prime creator in his divine image for us. I don't accept that harming ourselves, harming the beauty that was given to us, harming that essential divinity of yourself through eating what I call toxic foods, man-made foods, et cetera, and destroying that divine temple that you were born in, that's not acceptable. And that's also just an excuse in my mind. And so I don't encourage, when I work with people, I encourage accepting the beautiful soul you are within, but we need to excavate it the way that Michelangelo looked at the block of marble that was delivered to him, and he saw the David in it. All he had to do was take the pieces away that weren't David. So we need to go back to that within ourselves and carve away what isn't the divine. And so I'm not buying it.
I think that's really well said. And I agree with you. I think that's an excuse to just be as I am and not do anything to try to enhance, as you said, the divine body that we were given. So I agree with you. Mm-hmm. What about the fact that you've written all these successful books on the Clean Eating series? What does Tosca Reno eat in an average week? What is your diet like?
George, it's becoming more and more plant-based, and that is not because I don't eat meat. I do, but I was noticing this over the course of my eating. So let's say, for example, this morning, I had made muesli. And so muesli for me is a version of overnight oats that has chia seed, flax seed, grated apple, dates. I made my own oat milk, so plant-based milk, and I let that sit on the counter. A lot of people make overnight oats and put it in the fridge. You gotta let it get a little funky on the counter because it's the fermentation that properly prepares the grains that give you the more nutrients in the body. So breakfast would have been that. I've already had a liter of water. I've had a cup of coffee. I use organic coffee and I put oat milk in it. I have a lentil curry stew that I made myself. So that's going to be lunch. And the lentil curry stew is lentils, sweet potatoes, fresh carrots, onion, garlic, coconut milk. So the fat and coconut milk. And then I'll add some greens to that at the last minute. And that's lunch. I have snacks, hard-boiled eggs, with raw vegetables. In the afternoon, it'll be an apple and some nut butter. The apples are sitting right over there. And then dinner will be, I know tonight's going to be some grilled chicken breast. And I've already got a whole bunch of roasted vegetables. I cleaned them last night, asparagus, broccoli, and Brussels sprouts. And that's kind of a day of my eating. I'm not snacking on cookies and eating peanut butter by the jar like I used to.
So you're not a vegan or a plant-based eater solely, but you limit the amount of dairy and meat that you consume.
That's correct. And I'm impeccable about my choices of protein. I need to know that they're local. I'm lucky that I can access that here, where I can get an organic meat from range-free animals that have not been abused and lived in a concentrated feedlot. And I also make impeccable choices about my fat. I actually eat a lot of fat. I think more than in the days when I was competing, when fat was still considered a bad thing. So, you know, lots of avocado, coconut oil, avocado oil, olive oil, natural nut butters, nuts and seeds. Yeah.
The physique competitions, what was that like for you?
The preparation for a physique contest, George, as you likely know, is not for the faint of heart. There is a commitment to almost drudgery, right? There's going to be a period of time where you are in an absolutely focused state of eating a certain way and training a certain way, and there will be no variations on the theme. So whenever somebody asks me that question, you know, Tosca, can you help me get ready for contest? I think to myself, all right, here's what you got to know. You can't vary. If you expect to stand up on stage and compete with people who have committed themselves to the process for however long it takes to get there, you can't stand next to them and know that you've not committed and you've eaten your way through cookies and donuts. It just doesn't work. So the competition was important for me from the learning point of view. I had to learn what eating clean could do for me to change my body into an instrument. And the other thing I had to learn was how to shape it correctly using weight resistance training. I was less for cardio, but we tried to combine the cardio with my workouts. And of course, at the end, you're doing some cardio. And I learned that for a woman, I'm incredibly strong. And my peak, Bob was always amazed. He was my coach. That he said, your first two sets are always a throwaway, but somehow you get stronger as the sets go on. So that was an interesting thing to learn about myself. So I found the preparation for contest revealing, but I don't compete anymore because I don't think that's what my audience needs.
Okay. All right. So what do you do now to stay in such great shape? What does your weekly exercise regimen look like?
I strive to work out 5 to 6 days a week, and I frequently use my rebounder, which is the mini tramp, for my cardiovascular efforts because I find I can condense my workout. It's efficient. You can get the same cardiovascular and resistance benefit from using a rebounder for 15 minutes as running for 30 minutes. In fact, better, because with rebounding, you're getting three forces of gravity working on your muscles, which is acceleration, deceleration, and gravity. In weight training, resistance training, you're not getting that. So this helps. It also develops proprioception, flexibility, easy on back and knees. But George, I also absolutely love kettlebells. I'm newly tuned into working with kettlebells, and I love it's simple. You don't need a whole lot of equipment. And, you know, your body really is, it's your bench, it's your ball, it's your machine, it's everything. And you're just working with that weight. So I quite like it right now.
You, last time I interviewed you, and this was a while ago, I said, do you believe in the concept of aging as we define it in the West? And you had a pretty definitive response to that, what would you say now? What do you think of aging as we define it?
You know, George, there was a time in the Bible where the ancients lived 700 years old. My thinking today is, I believe, much like these processed foods we put on shelves, that we can believe we have a shelf life and you can live with it, but I choose not to. I don't think that we have to name an age as retirement or old or elderly. As soon as we name it, then we become it. So in my mind, I've always believed in the curiosity of youth, which to me gives that feeling of remaining young, even though I've had my 60th birthday already. I don't walk around in life with my curlers and my slippers on. You know, I'm going to go out there and I'm going to challenge what aging looks and feels like. Look, I was at a conference just this past weekend, and I had a gentleman come up to me who knew my story, who just basically said, I don't get this. My mind is not computing that you look the way you look when you've been through all of that. And I said, well, what should I look like? He said, you should look like hell, and you don't. You look incredible. And the thing is, it's not beauty what he's saying. What he's saying is there's a vitality, which I can see in you as well, a vitality. There's a youthfulness about the skin, a glow. That I didn't apply that. I didn't get it with knives. This comes from inside of me, and it's my belief that our youth is our, it lives in our DNA, and we can explode it out as long as we give it help, give it light.
Well, you are proof that health, fitness is not wasted on the young, and beauty, because no one would guess that you are 60 years old, that it's phenomenal. And it's a tribute to what you have done all these years and will continue to do. Now you can just see it.
I will.
Yes. So what would be...
Well, thank you. Back at you, George.
No. What would be your advice to people who are in their 60s, younger, because I've heard it, much younger or older, who have thrown in the towel and say, I give up the pills, the medication, the aches, the pains. This is the way I'm supposed to live. This is who I'm going to be. What would you say to them?
Again, going back to that, you know, George, going back to that idea of your life, what you see around you has all been delivered as a result of thought. So if your thought is that you bought what society, doctors, the food pundits, etc., have taught you, which is, well, you know, you're sick, you need this, you have symptoms, you need that, you know, retirement age is 65, don't push too hard, you know, it's not good for you, all of this stuff. When you believe those self-limiting beliefs, you will begin to live like that. That is what your life will roll out as. So I think what you choose to believe can be changed dramatically simply by saying no, rejecting all of that, right? Because life really is a series of, I said yes to this and I said no to that. So say no to that and say yes to a greater possibility. Say yes that within you lives something greater that perhaps you yourself haven't even seen within you, which is what happened to me. Living under all those excess pounds of weight, I couldn't see my own bright light, but I wanted something more. And so cherish that was there. It was implanted within you when you were born, and you have this within you, and you can carve away, like Michelangelo did, all the bits that aren't you and that can reveal the most beautiful divine self of you now. And that begins with taking steps. The first step might be do a round of striped sugar. You can find that on my website at ToscaReno.com. Do, start drinking water. One of the key things is we're so absolutely dehydrated. If you're drinking a lot of sugary beverages, you're also dehydrated. End of story. So 3 liters a day. And you'd be amazed what comes out of your body with 3 liters a day of water. So belief. When you believe, then everything unfolds from that.
At one time, you were a proponent of 6 meals a day, I believe. Are you still a proponent of that?
I find that as I am becoming more enlightened, so I've been doing a lot of spiritual work, I'm down to 5. I've been pushing my, so eating clean already has a fasting period built in because you're supposed to stop eating around 7 o'clock at night, and then you don't eat again until after your first workout in the morning, so around 9. So that is basically, people are asking about intermittent fasting. It's already built into eating clean. So what I find is that I now have my first meal around 9 after I've eaten. Today's my rest day, so an exception. And then I will eat my remaining 5 meals, stopping at around 7 o'clock at night. And yes, I still believe that in order to stay in the fat burning mode with thermogenesis, you need to have those regular, I call them injections of lean protein and macronutrients to get you staying in that really high fat burning zone. And that makes me feel the best. That helps me manage my blood sugar the best too.
What are the 3 E's that you are a proponent of?
So, George, in the beginning, when I had that first, moment of crisis on the steps of my Victorian house, the 2 pillars that were my study for the next 15 years were eating clean and exercise. I hadn't known about those things, but I became a student of them and a disciple, if you will. You may recall, in 2011, I had a series of crises. I'd experienced a lot of fame, a lot of success, but there was a correction coming. My stepson passed in 2011, and then Robert, whom I married, you alluded that we became husband and wife, he passed from cancer in 2012. And the following year, in 2013, I was forced to declare bankruptcy on his business, which had been insolvent for the 5 years leading to his death. So there were some terribly painful events and then the repercussions of those. And so I learned that I now needed to embark on an emotional wellness journey. And so the 3rd E is emotional self-care and really involves the practice of meditation, which I do. I did it today. I have embraced it. Now I love it. Journaling, and practicing things like gratitude, acceptance, forgiveness, lots of forgiveness at work here, and so much more of a spiritual connection to myself and my subconscious. And that has been that all-important final of the 3 E's.
When somebody looks at your profile and all the things you've accomplished, they would suggest that you have no problems. You're a New York Times bestseller, and you're beautiful and fit and healthy. But as you just described, you've had to deal with things that are horrific, but you've still come out because of your strength, because of your motivation, and probably a lot to do with the way you eat. You're still able to have a stable life and motivate other people. So what is your purpose? We kind of know that from what you've done, but what will be your purpose in the future? What are the things you're trying to accomplish?
My absolute focus is to break the system. I want to disrupt the way we think of wellness, and that in the breaking of the system, I can make it more clear to others how they can impact their wellness through the various strategies that I share with them. I'm a teacher. I'm a way shower. I'm someone who shines the light on things. And it comes from my experience and from my truth. And all progress begins with truth. So this is where I like to plant those seeds in people. I work with private coaching clients. I work with you know, out there with online programs, and I make myself available to them, and I will continue to shine that light and break the system and tell the truth about wellness, just as I had to learn, so that others can tap into their highest potential, which is ultimately the reason that you were placed here on this earth, because you are here to create.
Have you had to deal with any medical issues that have prevented you from following your path?
George, I am so blessed. I have had no medical issues, none. If there's going to be any medical issue, it's my stubborn mind that sometimes makes me overtrain. So, you know, that is something I find it hard to stop myself from doing. So I've had some issues with my shoulders, but, you know, I get the right people. I hire the pros to do the work that they need to do on my body because I can't massage myself. But no, I've been absolutely blessed. But I'm also, I seek every avenue of wellness I can get, from taking, you know, world-class supplements to exercise to yoga, stretching, cleansing myself, all the things, right? Everything. It's not just one thing. It's hundreds of daily habits.
You had mentioned supplements. What supplements do you take regularly?
So I take something called Age Lock Y-Span. If I were to narrow it down to the one that I couldn't do without, it would be Age Lock Y-Span. And it's a science-backed product that gathers 20 of the most highly nutritious plants from around the planet and puts them all into one capsule. And what these combined nutrients do is have an epigenetic effect on the genes of aging. So we have something called youth gene clusters, which have been identified, and it's been proven that this combination of nutrients can override and enhance and turn back the mitochondrial DNA so that you are, it can go back to, you know, 10, 20 years ago within yourself. So I found this has really helped my recovery. It's changed my hair, my skin, you know, just all kinds of positive things that I really don't like doing without. Plus it keeps me really healthy. Like, for example, with this coronavirus, I don't show up at the airport saying, okay, now I'm going to start sanitizing my hands and, you know, being immune. No. You're working on your immune system all day long, all year long. So you're bringing that sum total of your efforts, including exercise, including saying no to sugar, including taking supplements. That's what you're bringing to the table with your immune system. So I feel all those combined efforts and those particular supplements make a difference for me.
Well, you certainly motivate me and others by your lifestyle and the things you have to say. There's no question you're committed to what you're doing, and you're Thank taking you. An eclectic approach to it all, and it makes a lot of sense. Your microbiome is probably very healthy.
I eat a lot of fermented foods. Yeah.
If our viewers want to find out more about you, what would be the way to find out more about Tosca Reno? How would they contact?
I have a website, ToscaReno.com. I'm available on social media platforms under Tosca Reno or Eat Clean Diet. And if you write me at info@ToscaReno Media, you can find me there too. So tr@ToscaReno Media.com. And I am very good about answering emails. I've had longstanding relationships with clients from 20 years ago. And that's where you can find me.
Well, and I can tell you how kind you are, because I didn't know of Tosca 10 years ago. And my wife and my daughter kept saying, Dad, you've got to interview Tosca. And it was like Elvis. They didn't give me a last name, you know. Interview Tosca. So
I know.
So I told you how much my daughter idolized you. And you were kind enough to send her an autographed book. And she's forever grateful, and so am I. So thank you for being such a kind person and giving your time. And I hope our viewers appreciate what they're seeing. When this lady goes back to her class reunions, I have a strong suspicion she's by far the youngest looking and the most fit. Would that be acceptable compliment?
I probably make some people mad.
And I would say
they don't want to be showed up.
I would say read your books and follow your lifestyle, and they can have the same. Correct?
Exactly. It's for everyone. Yeah. Exactly. Thank you, George. Thank you for this beautiful opportunity. And I wanted to say, let's continue the hard and the good work that we do, because you also defy aging. And I believe that being the living example of what's possible is the greatest message we can send.
Absolutely. All right. Well, bless you. And we'll see you soon, Tosca. Maybe we can do this again when you're 70.
You got it.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you so much, George. Thank
Take
you.
Care. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
My motivation for wellness arose from my quest to find health and happiness. I just knew there was more for me. That change started when I took a serious look at my well-being. Once I figured out how, that source became my power and my career. Sharing my story of how to become the best version of me became my purpose and my path. That purpose blossomed when I discovered my story could and did help others. This is where I found my voice as a wellness guide. I developed a brand centered around rethinking lifestyle, where food and movement became fuel. And that led to success and positivity. Suddenly, life felt full of possibilities. I've written 25 books. I'm a New York Times bestselling author, a TV personality, and motivational speaker. I gained my million strong following not by telling people what to do, but by teaching them and by being their support throughout their journey, filled with triumphs and challenge. In doing so, they became my support, and together we have become resilient. I look forward to joining my friends on this new platform as we continue to fuel the wellness revolution and start this new chapter together. I'm ready to take my place.